Hello my dear students, welcome to my class. Today we are going to discuss a poem called The Echoing Green. The poet of the poem Echoing Green is William Blake. Children, William Blake was not a famous poet at all. In fact, during his lifetime, his work was not known to many people. But after 100 years of his death, people came to know about his work and his work has appreciated the society a lot. So that was about William Blake. Children, the poem was composed in the year 1789 in a book called Songs of Innocence. Children, the poem actually captures the events which happened throughout the spring day. The poet has beautifully captured the nature on a spring day, and it has also compared the different stages of life. First, a human being is a child, then he becomes young, and then he becomes old. So this life goes on and on. So let us see what is there in the poem, The Echoing Green. The sun does arise and make happy the skies. Children, imagine how the sky would be if there is no sun. The sky would always be dull. It would never have the fresh blue color there. It happens because of the beautiful glowing sun which we have. The sky looks so merry and happy in the morning. The merry bells ring to welcome the spring. Children, the merry bells here are the bells which are there on the church. They ring and they welcome the spring. Children, do you go out and play in parks during the summer season? Do you see the flowers there? Yes. So the poet says that the church bells which are ringing, they are welcoming the spring season. A spring morning they are welcoming. The skylark and the thrush, the birds of the bush. So now he further adds the songs of the birds. Children, have you ever listened to koel? She sings so beautifully. Just like koel, there are some more birds which sing a song. We also have nightingale which sings beautiful songs. So in this particular poem, the poet has used the names of the birds skylark and thrush. These are the kind of birds which sing in the morning. And that is why the poet has captured these birds in the poem. Sing louder around to the bell's cheerful sound. So poet further adds that the songs of the bird add up to the cheering sound of the church bells. Church bells themselves make a merry sound, and to add to the beauty of that sound, the birds also sing. While our sports shall be seen on the echoing green. Children, over here, who is our here? Here they are talking about the children who go out play in the fields or parks. So, in the morning time, everybody is in a happy mood. The children are playing and and therefore the environment around is very much happy and cheerful. So, in this particular stanza, the poet has appreciated the nature and it has appreciated the beauty of spring season. He says that during the spring season, the birds sing their song and welcome the spring flowers. The church bells also welcome the spring morning. So, and most importantly, he has appreciated the sun, which comes and makes the sky so lively. Next, the poet talks about an old man who is there and who is watching the kids play. Old John with white hair. So children, what is the name of the old chap in the poem? His name is John. And how do we know he is old? Because his hair are white. Just laugh away care. Sitting under the oak among the old folk. Children, when you are small right now, do you have any worries at all? But one day spend a time with your grandfather or even your parents. How much worries they have? But as children, you don't have any worry. And that is why over here, they are saying that John is sitting in the park and watching the children play different games. He has forgotten all his worries. So he is not a child that he does not have any worries. He has got n number of worries. But looking at the children sitting under the oak tree, he has forgotten about the problems that he has or the challenges that he has in life. He is simply sitting and watching the children play and spending the time with other friends of his own age. They laugh at our play, and soon they all say, such were the joys when all the girls and boys in our youth time were seen on the echoing green. So now, children, the poet says that when looking at these people, this group of old people are also remembering their own time when they were children, how they used to play in the fields, in the greens. They also did not have any worries at all, and they are just remembering their own time when they were also girls and boys and they used to play in the echoing green. Children, I would like you to see the rhyming scheme of this poem. I am reading this line. Please listen to me very carefully. The sun does arise. Children, what is the sound? What is the sound with which the line is ending? Z. And make happy the skies. So arise and skies are the rhyming words. So we would say, take this as AA. The merry bells ring to welcome the spring. So now again, ring and spring are the rhyming words. So it is BB. The skylark and thrush, the birds of the bush. Again, thrush and bush are the rhyming words. We would take this as CC. Sing louder around to the bell's cheerful sound. Around and round. We would take this as DD. While our sport shall be seen on the echoing green. So again, we would take this as EE. So now if we discuss about the rhyming scheme of the poem is AA, BB, CC, DT and EE. So other stanzas, the poem has three stanzas. The other stanzas also has the same rhyming scheme. So children, we have learned about the rhyming scheme of the poem. So let me also once again tell you the gist of the poem. The poet has actually captured the beautiful nature. Nature in that he is particularly appreciating the sun, the birds, the trees, right? And second thing, he is talking about the life cycle which happens in the life of a human being. First, we play as children. We have no worries at all. And then we become old like John. And our hair are white. And now we have experienced all kind of challenges in life. And looking at those children, we forget and we enjoy the time. So this is about Echoing Green Module 1. I will catch you again in Echoing Green Module 2. Thank you, children, for listening to the summary. Thank you.